Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In the Flame 2019.2 update, the file browsing experience has now been unified across the entire application. So if you've been using the file browser in the MediaHub, you will now have the same experience when loading setups, fonts, 3D models, media, and more. Certain functions that experienced artists may have used in the past are now available in the contextual menus or gear menus. So in terms of old functionality, everything is still there, but you now have the added functionality from the MediaHub model, which included extensive searching, breadcrumb navigation, and more. In addition to this, the bookmarks have also been rewritten from the ground up to give you a better user experience. This will now be covered in the remainder of this video. Let's return back to the MediaHub to check this out. When you click the Bookmarks pull-down menu, the bookmarks have now been separated into categories depending on where you want them available. For example, you have bookmarks per project. These bookmarks are only available for this project. You have bookmarks per user. These bookmarks are only available for this specific user profile in all projects. And finally, you have the shared bookmarks. These bookmarks are always available in every project with any user. And what is also handy to know is that the shared bookmarks will also be available across all software versions. So you can be quite specific to where and when you want bookmarks to appear. What's even more advantageous to know is that all these bookmarks are saved as editable XML files. These can be imported and exported through Flame, and you can customize them for a multi-system and multi-production pipeline workflow. We'll look at some of that later on. As for just creating a bookmark, the starting point is still the same. You navigate to the folder or directory location, click the bookmark pull-down menu, and choose to add a bookmark. Next, you get a pop-up window with three options. Firstly, you would choose a category. This determines whether your bookmarks are project-based, user-based, or shared globally. If you had created any subfolders within the categories, you could place your bookmarks there, or you could also do that when you manage the bookmarks at a later point. Secondly, the default name of the bookmark is based on the current folder or directory in the MediaHub. There is a preference to turn off auto-naming, but you can also manually edit the name if you choose. It's totally down to you and your production pipeline. But if you left the text box empty, Flame will simply use the file path to identify the bookmark. This name can also be modified later on. Finally, you have the last option, which is visibility. This determines where in the application the bookmark will be available. Currently, it is set to global. This means that every browser in Flame will display this bookmark. If you toggle the visibility to MediaHub files, this bookmark will only appear in this browser when you're browsing files in the MediaHub. Depending in which browser you create the bookmark will determine what visibility settings you can choose. For example, you can restrict the bookmarks to specific browsers within certain parts of the software, such as loading setups, archiving, and even conforming with set path. You can set all these options when creating the bookmark, but you can also change it later when managing the bookmarks. Click Add, and your bookmark is available in the pull-down menu. Now, if you want to edit the bookmarks, you click the pull-down menu and choose to manage the bookmarks. The bookmark window appears, and every aspect is editable. Just select and click on any entry. And using the contextual menu, you can add new folders, rename, cut, copy, delete, etc. You can even have folders within folders to manage your organization. You can even shift bookmarks between categories, as well as arrange their order. Now, I did mention earlier in the video that you can edit the bookmarks. So you can adjust the name and the path, but there is also the ability to perform bulk editing. For example, If you copied the bookmarks to another project and need to change the path to the different folders, you can just select the bookmarks and edit them as a single operation. You can show the name and the path as a preference to check the details if required. Next, with each of the bookmarks, you can also see their visibility settings in the visibility column. So if you choose a specific visibility setting when you created the bookmark, you can change it here easily. As an extra point, it is possible to have specific project bookmarks that point on other real groups and batch groups in other projects. So bookmarks are not just for the standard file system. For example, you could bookmark within a specific project to access your common graphics. But see that the visibility says MediaHub projects, and it is locked and grayed out. For obvious reasons, this bookmark will only be visible when browsing Flame projects and not any other part of the application. Now, as you become more savvy with the bookmark system, you can also use a series of tokens similar to OpenClip and Pattern Browsing. For example, I'll close the Bookmark Manager and navigate to this series of productions. In each of these folders, I'm using a set structure of directories, and I've already bookmarked Episode 1. Let's look at the rushes. So Episode 2, 3, and so on will have the same folder structure to keep the production pipeline consistent. So your main directory for each production, or in my case each episode, is named differently, but contains a series of identically named folders. Now, through the use of tokens, you can define your bookmark paths in a dynamic way. Open the Bookmark Manager again, and look at the file path for each of the episode's folders. The folder token is used in place of the production or episode name in the file path. So the folder containing these bookmarks is named exactly as the main directory folder containing these materials on the file system. So currently, it is pointing to Episode 1. Now let's say you are moving on to Episode 2, and you don't really want to manually redo all the bookmarks. You could do bulk editing as before, but tokens give you another dynamic option. Since the folder structure is the same, and only the main directory name changes, all you need to do is edit the folder name. Change it to Episode 2, and this will instantly update all the bookmarks to look at Episode 2's folders. If I close the Bookmark Manager and navigate to the Episode 2 rushes, they are now available super fast. So tokens are really powerful. But if we return to the Bookmark Manager, I just want to mention that these tokens need to be typed in manually for this release of Flame, and they are case sensitive. So the folder containing the bookmarks must match the actual name of the folder in the file structure. So if you copy these bookmarks to another project to do the next episode or production, you just need to change the name of the bookmark folder and not all the bookmarks. The bookmarks will then read the directory structure and point to all the correct locations. This essentially allows you to automate your bookmarks as you switch productions and projects. Now here is a slide of the list of tokens currently available in the Flame 2019.2 update. So you can choose to use these tokens, or there is bulk editing like you saw earlier. Now if you wish to export the bookmarks from Flame, you would go to the main preferences, and in the general menu, you can find the Import, Export, and Manage Bookmarks button. When you export, all the bookmarks will be collated into a single file, and you can take that wherever you want. Inversely, when you are importing bookmarks, you would load the same file through the Import button. Please note that this will overwrite existing bookmarks and not append. However, if you import a bookmark file that only contained a single category, only that category will be overwritten, and the other existing categories will remain the same. What is also key to note is before exporting to a single bookmarks file, or after importing a single bookmarks file. The active bookmarks are kept in three single XML files that relate to the three categories: project, user, and shared. The reason for separating the bookmarks into separate files is that you can modify these XMLs and only affect specific bookmark categories, either manually or through Python scripts, to further automate your pipelines and project setup. If you edit any of these files live during a Flame session, they will automatically update in the Bookmarks pull-down menu after the XMLs have been saved. The backend of this design is very open, but exporting will create one convenient file, and importing will take that file and split it into the three XML category files. Another way of copying individual categories is during project and user creation. For the project, you can choose to copy a previous project's bookmarks, and the same goes for copying a previous user's profile's bookmarks. Once they're copied or imported, you can edit them via the Manage Bookmarks window, or for more script-oriented people, you can edit the XMLs as well. So bookmarks have definitely taken a step up in the Flame 2019.2 update. Lastly, the one other addition to the file browser is session history. This refers to the paths you have visited in the file browser and performed either an importing or bookmarking operation. The path will also be remembered if you typed it by hand and not navigated to it via the file browser. So you can get back quickly to the paths you've currently been using and bookmark them if you didn't in the first place. Flame will remember the last 30 paths you visited, and this is available in all instances of the file browser. But please be aware that the session history is not persistent. Once you restart Flame, the session history is cleared, and new paths will start being remembered for the new active session. Standardizing your file browsing experience, as well as providing a new enhanced bookmark system, should hopefully help you find your files when you need them. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2019.2 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.